Honourable Member for Kirkfield Park.
Mr. Speaker, cardiac arrest can strike without warning, and indeed, 85% of the time, it happens outside of a hospital. And we know that rapid access to a defibrillator can mean the difference between life and death. And that's why, just last year, our government introduced legislation to ensure defibrillators are available in more places so that the devices can be easily accessed in these critical moments to save more lives in our province. I was wondering if our Minister of Health could please provide an update to the House and to all Manitobans on this first-in-Canada life-saving legislation.
The Honourable Minister of Health.
Yes, thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. And granted, we do spend a lot of time in question period and otherwise with the thrust and parry and back and forth, but I would say, with respect to all members of this House, that we are all today, I believe, to be commended for the work that Manitoba has done in bringing defibrillator legislation and its public access to be the first of its kind in Manitoba. I've had good advice, Mr. Speaker, from the member from River Heights, the member from Riding Mountain, the member from Charleswood, the member from Thompson, from you, Mr. Speaker, in bringing forward the best legislation that I believe every jurisdiction in Canada will copy so that we can bring defibrillators into the public forum, Mr. Speaker, so we can reduce sudden cardiac arrest incidences, save lives 75% of the time. Today, I say we should all stand together and be proud of this because I believe that we've done this together, Mr. Speaker.